I was so excited about Polygon. It sounded great. I mean, who wouldn't want to pay 99% less in transaction fees? That's the point of Polygon. Polygon was built on top of Ethereum, and because it has the ability to mint NFTs and swap currencies at a very low rate, it is very useful. Polygon, also known as Matic, is one of the leading proof-of-stake cryptocurrencies today. So why do only 20% of Ethereum holders use it? TLDR? It's inconvenient. Every tutorial that I came across for Polygon skimped out halfway, and some were even posted with typos in the network configuration settings. There was no clear starting point for me when I got into Polygon, and I still see crypto day traders confused about the network. At any rate, let's get into it, because this is a tutorial video. Step 1. Purchase Polygon. You don't need a lot of Polygon to get started, so $20 should be enough to get you onto the Matic network. I would recommend purchasing Polygon from an exchange like Coinbase, and then transferring that directly to MetaMask. I don't recommend using another tool for currency swapping at the moment, because this tutorial is designed to set you up better for currency swaps. Step 2. Have MetaMask. You need MetaMask. There's no way around it. You can add it as a browser extension or install it as an app on your phone. MetaMask is like the Facebook login button for the darknet. You can conveniently carry your MetaMask account across multiple apps and services, all while getting access to a great wallet that can work well with Polygon. Step 3. Set up the Matic network on your MetaMask wallet. You can do this by clicking the MetaMask icon in your browser, selecting the network, which is usually Ethereum mainnet, and choosing the last option, Custom RPC. This will let you connect to a new server. Enter Polygon as a network name, an RPC URL, such as https://polygon-rpc.com, a chain ID of 137, MATIC as the currency symbol, and https://polygonscan.com in the last row. This is where most guides stop. They fail to mention step 4, use Polygon. There are like 3 different landing pages for Polygon, and people are still referring to it as Matic, even though they changed the name back in February. So when I first started out, I had no idea that I had to go to wallet.polygon.technology to actually use Polygon. You'll want to connect your MetaMask there and take advantage of 2 features, the Polygon Wallet and the Polygon Bridge. Why they decided to keep these features separate from each other, I don't know. But in order to cash out the wrapped Ethereum or WETH that you may have received in a sale or transfer Matic into Polygon for your first swap, you'll need to use the Polygon Bridge. Step 5. Transfer Matic into the Polygon network. First, you'll need to make sure that you're connected to the Matic network on MetaMask. Once you confirm that you're connected, transfer the Matic from the Ethereum mainnet to the Matic mainnet, using a Plasma bridge. If you're on the right page, it's easier to do than it sounds. Note, you could also convert a different crypto to Matic at this point using the Plasma bridge, but the fees will be higher for including the currency swap. And yes, there is an Ethereum gas fee for every time you use the Plasma bridge. I know. In order to avoid paying gas fees with Matic, you'll have to pay a gas fee with Matic. The fee on Ethereum NFT transfers has been around $80 lately, so you'll only want to use the Matic network for currency swaps if you plan on swapping a currency more than once. So, how do we do it? Step 6. Go to another website that no one told you about. QuickSwap. On QuickSwap, you can connect your MetaMask wallet to the Matic mainnet in order to finally get those currency swaps that you've been searching for. The tool is fairly straightforward, and it links back to the Polygon network if you click Bridge Assets on the top right. Just switch the bridge from Polygon to Ethereum by clicking the switch icon in the Polygon bridge, and you're good to go. You may be interested in using Polygon to mint NFTs and transfer them at a low price, But keep in mind that as of October 2021, OpenSea has set the default property of all newly transferred Matic NFTs as hidden. I fully support this decision because people were taking advantage of the publicity that NFTs would get after transferring them to another user and displaying them publicly on their OpenSea profile. In this economy, whatever generates interest generates revenue. So Matic users loaded up and spammed NFTs across the network since it was such a cheap option to gain attention. Eventually, this led to people unknowingly having NFTs that were unfiltered and inappropriate. Now, the only difference is that you can hide those NFTs from your profile and sell them without anyone ever really knowing that you had them. Isn't that a better user experience? Well, everyone, thanks for watching. I hope this video cleared up some things today about Polygon and the Matic network. If you want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe and let me know in the comments. That's all for this time. Come join me next time. Kyle and out.